when the horses near the turn for home, the old dream was about to become reality.
And here comes Sea Hero, charging through on the inside with Jerry Bailey. And down the stretch they come. Sea Hero on the inside up to take the lead.
Down the stretch into racing history came Sea Hero. The old dream had come true for the old friends. They had won the Kentucky Derby.
Time it was, and what a time it was, it was. A time of innocence, a time of confidences.
Mac Miller, at age 71, has finally reached the goal of every trainer. Paul Mellon, a man of great wealth at age 85, is far richer in spirit now than he was 2 weeks ago. But hold on, there may be more. Neither man has ever won the Preakness.
Well, good afternoon. It is a good afternoon. I'm Jim McKay at Pimlico, where old friends meeting is the theme of the day. Paul Mellon and Mac Miller will meet again, and Sea Hero and Jerry Bailey will again meet some of the friendly rivals they found in the Kentucky Derby. From the 19 horses who started in the Derby, of course, only one now has a chance to win the Triple Crown, to become the 12th Triple Crown winner and the first in 15 years. That, of course, is Sea Hero, but right now he is not the favorite. In fact, he's third choice in the betting. The horse who finished second to him in the Derby, Prairie Bayou, is the favorite at 5-2, and Personal Hope is second choice at 7-2. Of course, both of them back here to challenge again. So also are horses like Union City and Wild Gale, seven Derby horses altogether, plus five newcomers, making for a field of 12.
$1.2 million pool. Pistols and Roses has 15 points. He's the co-leader with Missionary Ridge. Pistols and Roses is here. Missionary Ridge is skipping this race. Devil His Due is here. He has 11 points. He's third. Latin American, who won the Californian, has 10 points. And Irish Swap, who unfortunately had to be humanely destroyed because of an injury last month, accumulated a total of 8 points. Now we have a six-horse field. Since this is a handicap race, the horses have been assigned weights. Conte de Savoia was assigned 110, 2 pounds over at 112 now. Jerry Bailey up at 12-1. Valley Crossing is the longest shot on the board at 16-1. And then you have the co-favorite, Devil His Due, the high weight in the race at 120 at 8-5. Pistols and Roses carries just 114. He's 4-1. Strike the Gold is the other co-choice at 8-5. And Ibex, a most interesting horse, at 7-1. Strike the Gold, as Jim said, an old friend, now a five-year-old. Craig Peretta's up. This will be his 30th career start. He's already earned more than $3.4 million. He's trained by Nick Zito, who had this to say about him.
Maybe he's the James Dean of the racetrack.
2 years ago, Strike the Gold struck gold in Louisville, but the blanket of roses wilted 2 weeks later when the horse ran an uninspired sixth in the Preakness. That began a streak of 12 races without a win, while behind the scenes his owners played out a fractious and contentious partnership from hell. So Strike the Gold went to the auction block and was bought back by two of the original partners for $2.9 million. 4 days later, the horse captured the Pimlico Special. He'd go on to win the $750,000 bonus for the American Championship Racing Series. And then after going to the post 13 times in 1992, he spent the next 5.5 months away from the races.
You know, it's possible he was tired. He ran all year. He didn't miss a race, didn't miss a dance. Never once didn't perform in a grade one. I mean, you know, every race was a grade one. And he was gallant most of the time. He tried.
Following the long layoff, the now five-year-old returned to the track with a 3.5-length victory in an allowance race at Aqueduct 3 weeks ago. And the roguish horse still inspires analogies from his trainer.
Sir Lawrence Olivier might have been a better actor than James Dean, but I'll tell you what, you still talk about James Dean.
There are the men, or one of the men anyway, who bought out B. Giles Brophy, William Condren, and Joe Cornaccia. Now the owners of Strike the Gold. Is another trip to the winner's circle at hand? We'll find out.
To the front. There's the Grey Colt, Pistols and Roses. The track and stakes record set by Farm Away, winning the Pimlico Special. And there is Strike the Gold, Kentucky Derby winner of 1991. And Ibex, is the last horse to move into line. Mike Smith rides. He'll be riding Prairie Bayou in the Preakness. They're all in line, ready for the start.
No.
Pistols and Roses, who is fractious in the post parade, acting up just a bit now.
No.
They're off. And Strike the Gold got squeezed a bit at the start. And from between horses, Devil His Due takes the early lead. But now Ibex on the outside charges up. And Ibex takes command by one. Devil His Due is second. Ponte de Savoy at the rail. And Pistols and Roses now moves quickly to Great Hope on the outside. As they go to the clubhouse turn, Ibex leads it by a length and a quarter. Devil His Due with Herb McCauley saving ground on the inside. On the outside, Pistols and Roses now takes the second spot. Devil His Due back to third. Gap of two, and on the outside, that's Valley Crossing. Then Conte de Savoia at the rail, and five and a half lengths back to the trailer, Strike the Gold, who is 13 lengths from the lead. As they move on to the backstretch, Mike Smith has Ibex on an easy length and three-quarter advantage. With Pistols and Roses into the second spot by a tight length, Devil His Due at the rail is right there third, then two and a half back in Valley Crossing, then a gap of two, and Conte de Savoia, and Strike the Gold is still sixth and last. He has not started his move. They go to the far turn. Ibex leads it by three parts of a length on the outside. That's Pistols and Roses second. Along the inside, Devil His Due is racing third. And somebody threw something onto the racetrack as they moved at the half-mile pole. Looked like a baton of some sort. They're midway on the turn. And Ibex on the inside has the lead. But here comes Pistols and Roses charging up on the outside. Middle of the racetrack, Devil His Due is on the move. Strike the Gold is still absolutely last. He'll have to make up eight lengths in the stretch. Three of them across the track, and down the stretch they come. And Devil His Due on the outside takes command three parts of a length. Along the inside, Pistols and Roses dropping back. Valley Crossing with a big late move. A 16th of a mile to go. And Devil His Due with Herb McCauley aboard will try and hold off the late charge of Valley Crossing. Here's the finish. Devil His Due wins it by a length and a quarter. Valley Crossing second by two. And Pistols and Roses, the Great Colt, was third. The final time, 1:55 2/5 seconds, and it was Devil His Due who stopped that early pace. Ibex, as expected, charged out to the front, but Devil His Due taking the time, and with that absence of real brisk, fast early foot, Devil His Due now has enough points to go to the lead in the American Championship Racing Series. Strike the Gold just never fired this afternoon, closing as the second choice at 8-5, and with Craig Perrett as regular rider aboard, he simply did not have it. The times of the splits, the quarter, not fast at all, 24, the half and 47-3. They were racing a lot faster than that earlier this afternoon. The mile in 1:35 4, and the final time, 1:55 2/5 seconds, 3 full seconds off Farm Away's track and stakes record. Jim? Wins it. He pays 460, 340, and 260. Valley Crossing winds up second, paying 940 and $4. And Pistols and Roses with third, paying 320. The $2 exacta, 3 and 2, pays $66.40. And as I'm joined by Dave Johnson, let's go back to take a look at the race. And at the start of the race, as you called at the beginning, Dave, number 5, Strike the Gold, was squeezed. He was pinched at the beginning.
Yes. Ibex on the outside will move in and will, unfortunately, Strike the Gold will take the worst of it there. Not enough to lose him the race, though. And you'll see Devil His Due over here get a very clean break. And with that bumping, Pistols and Roses gets involved. You'll also see Herb McCauley look over his right shoulder and actually see the problem. But Strike the Gold is simply gathered back by Craig Perrett, and Ibex set sail to the front with Mike Smith.
Ibex set sail to the front, and Pistols and Roses was right there. And you mentioned something was thrown onto the track. Let's see if we can catch it on the replay. The lower portion of the screen, we're being told, and something is thrown from what is that huge throng in the infield, but apparently it did not reach the racing surface.
And as we watched the stretch, Devil Is Due, who had set the rail, and the rail is good today for the front runners who stay on the rail, or from horses who stay on the rail for 80% of the race and then come off to win it, as Herb McCauley brightly did this afternoon. He gets into Devil Is Due, takes command, and wins it, carrying the top weight of 120 pounds. He's now won three straight. His last race was the Excelsior at Aqueduct, and he comes home here in beautiful weather on Preakness Day in the ACRS.
And McCauley, as mentioned before, was the fellow who broke his collarbone 3 weeks ago in New York. Would have had a Derby mount in Wallenda, was taken off that, and comes back today to win the Pimlico Special. Let's check in with Charlsey.
Well, the early fractions were moderate, as we expected, and it wound up being a definite detriment to strike the goal. Nick Zito, he never really got out of a good gallop.
Well, Craig said he just never grabbed the hold of the track either. I can't understand it, because I thought he was going to run a beautiful race today, but he just never got a hold of this racetrack. Wayne Lucas told me it was a little loose, and maybe there is some to it, but I'm sorry, no excuse, but he just never got a hold of it.
The 47-3 they ran today was the same pace that he was able to fire against and win the special last year.
That's exactly right, Charles. He just never got a hold of it, and I don't have a concrete excuse right now. I hope he's okay. He acts okay. He came back. All right, we'll see what happens.
Hope so, too. Small races often provide big surprises, Al.
All right, Charlsey, and as you might suspect, the reaction of those in the owner's box. Alan Jerkins is the trainer of Devil Is Due. His wife is the lady in the red outfit right there. Jerkins is a Hall of Fame trainer, noted for upsets. Not an upset today, but another big win. Another big win for the Hall of Fame trainer. And there is the official order of finish. Devil Is Due wins it by a length over Valley Crossing. Pistols and Roses finishes third, three lanes back. Conta de Savoia, then Ibex, and Strike the Gold finishes last. So last year he won the race, and this year he finishes well up the track. After four of the nine races now in the American Championship Racing Series, Devil Is Due has 21 points with that first place finish today. Pistols and Roses now has 20 points. Missionary Ridge with a total of 15, Latin American with 10, Irish Swap with 8, and Devil Is Due will also pick up a $150,000 mid-season bonus in addition to the lion's share of the $600,000 overall purse. Pistols and Roses with a $100,000 bonus by virtue of his performance. Thus